Hey everybody out there in TV land, Eddie the Tattooed Realtor reporting live from outside in my backyard here in lovely Margate, Florida. I hope this video finds you well whenever you may be watching it, day, night, evening, whenever and wherever. So before we get into the meat and potatoes of this particular video, which I'm super excited about, I encourage you to please give that subscribe button a click. If you're watching this on YouTube, if you're watching this on Facebook, give that button a like or a follow. So this video is about this whole pandemic thing that's happening in our country, in the nation, in the world as a whole, and how as a realtor you can make the most of this time and what I'm doing and what I'm implementing and some ideas to kind of get those juices flowing, especially since here in Broward County they put that mandate down that they don't want people leaving unless you're essential. Yes, real estate is deemed essential, but they're still restricting or eliminating showings and open houses and that kind of stuff. So it's gonna make your business a little more difficult. So these are a couple of ideas. We'll just go through a handful of what you can do during this time of relaxation and isolation in order to grow your real estate business. So first off, we've talked in other videos about identifying your farming area, your ideal customer, your ideal client, how you can attract them, how you can work with them, how you can, you know, kind of figure out what they're looking for. And so now we're gonna talk about some tools and assets that you can use and how to put them into effect to grow your real estate business and to keep it moving forward during this time when we're all kind of locked in. So the first idea, number one, that I had. Because many people are at home and they are still delivering mail, I highly recommend that you look into that lot. The other videos I've made about EDDM, every door direct marketing, or mail marketing, however you want to phrase it. The reason why I recommend that you look into mail marketing is because, well, people are at home, they have a little more time, they have a little more, they're just stuck there. So you know where they're at. Since you know where they're at, why not send a very intriguing piece, you know, talking about the neighborhood or talking about, you know, homes that are sold in the area or talking about like that you're just there for them or that you're, you know, you're bringing them hope or you know, you're bringing them ideas that they may not have otherwise thought about. The reason I recommend the marketing and the mail marketing is once again because it's fairly affordable and the postal system is still working and people are at home. That's the first idea. Now, when it comes, actually, you know what? I had an idea to that idea. Now, when it comes to EDDM, you can set up the route, you can get the bulk pieces, you can do all that kind of stuff. If you want to take the time and go more direct, pick up a book of stamps, let's say 100 stamps, right? 100 stamps, 100 envelopes, and you're going to type up a letter and you're going to sign it in pen. And then what you're going to do is on the envelope itself, if you can pick up a funky color, like maybe like a blue or a green or a purple, something other than white, you're going to write in blue or black ink on the actual card and you're going to put your return address and you're going to make it look more organic, more original as opposed to a mass produced piece. And then you're going to hand pick who you're going to deliver. Maybe you're going to deliver it to people that you know who have been putting off selling their home for X amount of time, and so you're going to encourage there. Or maybe you know there's a family in need and you're going to write a letter there of encouragement. Maybe you're going to provide some information to that neighbor who's been thinking about selling. Boom. You're just going to provide that information. So first idea, mail marketing, because you know they're at home and they probably have a little bit more time to look at it. The next idea, or the next notion, if you will, is to keep productive in your social media, keep productive in your blog, your WordPress, your videos, whatever it is, keep productive in it, because I've been noticing like a rampant epidemic or pandemic, if you will, that people have stopped. They've stopped posting pictures of homes or listing. They've stopped posting pictures of inspiration. They've stopped posting pictures about their business. They've stopped posting pictures or stopped posting or creating in general because they kind of went on that standstill. My ideology, my thought is keep fighting when no one's fighting. Keep hunting when no one's hunting. Keep moving forward regardless of what the other people are doing, because this is a time for us to get ahead, okay? So keep being productive. Second idea, be productive. Create that content, create these videos, have some fun with it. Let people know that you're there. Be a beacon of hope for them during these trying times. I guarantee you they'll remember it. The other idea that I was having when it came to all this real estate stuff is to begin to become familiar with your tools and assets that you have at your disposal from your association. You're at home, you have the interweb, you're able to dig deep. First off, anybody you have automated searches for, you need to check on those daily if you're not already doing it. You need to add notes in those comments to show engagement. You need to call them and talk to them or text message them or message them through Instagram or Facebook. Just be in contact with them, okay, about those particular properties. On your association, you might have things like Remind. We made videos about that. Use Remind to your advantage. You might have RPR. We made videos about that. We have all these resources as realtors, so this is the time to take advantage of your time that you have and learn them even more thoroughly. So you have three ideas. First one, mail marketing. Second idea, stay consistent with your content, with your creation. Be consistent, don't give up. Next thing, online marketing, okay? Use that time, or not online marketing, excuse me, the association, the tools in your association that are online, make use of those tools. I guarantee you that will be helpful to you. And another idea that I had during these trying times is video creation. Yes, you are watching this on YouTube. Yes, I like to make YouTube videos. I like to make videos in general, keep the content fresh and interesting. And so, because of that, I want to challenge you. You don't need a Canon like I have. You don't need a Rode mic like I have. You don't need a tripod like I have. You don't need some fancy dancy, you know, system set up. Literally, you just need this. You just need your cell phone. If you don't have a stand to put your cell phone on, hold it. If you don't have someone to, or if you don't have a stand and you're not able to hold it, have one of your kids hold it for you. Have your husband or your significant other or your wife hold it for you. Start video creating. Also, on the note of video creation, I haven't really gotten into it, excuse me, heavily yet, but I have another channel, as we talked about with the arcade, Flynn's, that I've been messing around with, which I find is very fascinating when it comes to real estate. And I haven't executed yet, but that doesn't mean that you can't start it now, and that's TikTok. Now, TikTok is a different type of social media application that you may or may not have learned about, or may not know about. But what I'm noticing with TikTok as a realtor, you have endless opportunity because I don't see a lot of realtors on TikTok, at least from my exploring. The thing with TikTok is heavily reliant upon, you know, the younger population, because that's what they're on. It's helping them digest more information, more content quicker. So that's not necessarily the ideal customer, but you know what? Those potential people on there could turn into customers and clients one day, or they might have family or friends. And I'm not saying everybody's super young on there. There are people my age, 30 plus or whatever. And I think it's a matter of time before we see this pivot where a lot more realtors begin to get on TikTok because of its endless opportunities, really, and what you can make use of it. So anyways, guys, there are a couple ideas. I hope that my video finds you well, whatever country you're in, whatever state you're in. I hope that you're not being fearful. Remember, fear is just false evidence appearing real. And I thank you so much for watching this video to the end. Once again, my name is Eddie Acevedo, a realtor here in Broward and Palm Beach for over 9 years, otherwise known as Eddie the Tattooed Realtor. Give the subscribe button a click if you can. Follow us on Facebook as well. We're on Instagram, getting more and more content out there consistently. Hope you have an amazingly blessed day, and I'll catch you guys on the flip side. Talk to you later.